going to work. On their daily trips, commuters shed tears now, use American flags like veiled women to hide their sorrows, rush to buy throwaway cameras to capture your twin ghost. Frantically, I too purchase your memory on postcards and coffee mugs, in New York City souvenir shops, afraid I'll forget your facade, forget my hollowed Sunday morning PATH train rides. My subway travels through the center of your belly day after day. Afraid I'll forget your powers to transform helicopters into ladybugs gliding in the air, to turn New York City into a breathing map, to display the curvature of our world.
This poem begins, on their daily trips, commuters shed tears now. Tell me about this poem, Going to Work. What did you want to do?
Actually, I was lucky because I used to have to take the subway every day to go to work and go through the World Trade Center. And that first day, 9/11, I was not there because I had just gotten into a graduate program, so I was upstate. And
you were out of town.
I was out of town, and it was my first day of of school. And so that's what I thought about, was going through there every day. And I used to come every Sunday when I lived in New Jersey, used to commute on the PATH train to come through the World Trade Center and take my bike and ride it around there every Sunday. That was like a religious thing for me. Mm-hmm. And I don't know, there was something about those towers that I really loved. I used to stand right underneath them and look straight up, and they used to get dizzy from, they looked like they were moving. Mm-hmm. They were like alive, I think, you know. I mean, I do obviously think of the people who perished there, but I also think of the destruction of the towers themselves, and I consider them to have been architectural artwork that was destroyed, and so I was very sad about that.
So did you write this soon after, several years after? How did that work?
Yeah, no, it was pretty soon after. I also felt that I needed to get back into New York somehow. Spiritually, I needed to be in the city to give my person to New York. And I thought, if I have to pay taxes, I'll pay them to New York City. So I moved, I hurried up my studies and finished in a couple years and went right back.
Now, do you write this out of some compulsion? Were you compelled to write? Because I know you wrote several other 9/11 poems, mm-hmm. at least three others that I've seen.
Yes.
Did you feel compelled to do that?
I did. I felt compelled because I felt somehow that I owed it to the city of New York, whatever little bit I could do. And so it was like a compelling, it was a feeling that I had that I had to get it out and put it on paper and express what I felt. So it was a
and is that different from your normal writing? What usually gets you going that makes you feel you have to write?
Well, a big thing for me is injustice of any kind. I don't like injustice of any kind. So that is something that compels me to write. I do write sometimes when I'm not necessarily compelled in that way, and then those poems take a lot longer and they go through a lengthier editing process. But when I'm compelled to write, when I get angered by something that I believe is unjust or violence or anything of that sort.
You know, you mentioned thinking about the people in those towers. One of the other poems that you wrote was for the iron workers.
Yes.
Right? Mm-hmm. Thinking about the people who built those towers and then the ones who came and helped tear down the remnants. Yeah.
That was also a poem that I was compelled to write because I was going to Staten Island to do a reading with another great poet who since has passed. And we had to go shortly right after the 9/11 incident. So there was no traffic downtown. So the So the taxi left us at a certain point. We had to walk from there to the ferry, and it was nighttime, and we walked right by the what they used to call it, the pit. And it was very it was like a nightmare. It was like a nightmare because it was night. There were glaring lights on the pit, and there was smoke still rising from there, and you could smell the burnt metal, steel, and then, you know, you saw almost like the shadows of the iron workers, and you heard them taking apart that steel and bringing the rest of that down and cleaning it up. So,
yes, I want to ask you finally, because you do live in Manhattan. Mm-hmm. Well, where do you see things 10 years later? Did 9/11 have an impact in ways that you still see and feel?
Well, I've always had a great love for the city of New York. So I still have that lingering feeling this far out from 9/11. I think it's had a certain impact in the sense that people are in New York maybe a little bit different, and the atmosphere sort of feels a little bit different in New York itself. Mm-hmm. In terms of the country, I hope that it has had an impact for the better. I unfortunately see so many things that are not really too good in terms of the politics of the country. Not so much with the administration that's in now, not at all that, but with the Tea Party and these other factions that have come up. And I see that as very divisive and unfortunate because, you know, of course, I'm an artist, I guess, a poet, a writer, so I believe we should all get along and there should be peace in the world. And so it's an unfortunate thing in that sense. So it's weird. It's sort of gone both ways. Nationally, it's gone one way, and locally, it's gone another, I believe. That's what I get.
All right, Nancy Mercado, thanks for reading, and thanks for talking to us.
Thank you.